The Xiaomi Mi AirDots are great, but because of reseller markup and limited availability, I think that there's a better option for a truly wireless headphone under $40. Hey, my name is Mitchell. If you're new to my channel, I make videos about the tech I use, things like cell phones, tablets, and drones. And if you're looking to pick up the QCY T1 Pro headphones after this video, I have a special coupon link in the description down below. It's only good for the first 30 people. Also, in complete transparency, I would like to thank GearBest for sending me these headphones to review. But just because they were provided for me free of cost doesn't mean that I'm going to look at using them any differently or give them a favorable review. Most of the Xiaomi products I get already are bought at little to no cost to me because of the profit I make from YouTube ad revenue and because of viewer support. So the unboxing experience for these headphones is pretty good. The packaging is pretty slim, it's pretty minimalistic kind of, and I like the included micro USB cable. It just feels pretty high quality. You get three pairs of ear fins as well as three different size ear gels. And overall, as a product, I think it's quite complete. They use Bluetooth 4.2, so it's not going to have any of the added benefits of Bluetooth 5.0, being the extra low energy or the extra range. They have 3.5 to 4 hours of battery life. The case that they come with claims an extra 6 recharges of the headphones, and I can tell you from experience, I charged these headphones up on a Sunday with the case. It is Saturday right now, and I still have half of the charge left on the case. Compared to my Mi AirDots, which I had to charge more than once a week. I'm really, really happy with the battery life on these. And if you guys want to see a comparison between the QCY T1 Pro and the Xiaomi Mi AirDots, go ahead and let me know in the comment section down below. The headphones also have an IPX4 splash and water resistance to resist any sweat. And I have to say, I was walking home one day in the rain and one of the earbuds fell out of my pocket. I'd put them in my pocket because I was doing something else at the time. And it fell in a puddle, was completely submerged. I picked the headphone up, I cleaned it off with some water, and they function totally fine. So it's great to see that even at a really budget price, we do have a certain amount of water ingress protection built into them. To quickly touch on the design, we have a really nice metal feeling case that pushes out to reveal the headphones themselves. The case has an LED indicator on the back by the charging port with 4 LED lights, which indicate how much charge the case has left. I would have liked to have seen USB Type-C here, but micro USB at this price is completely acceptable. The inside of the case is lined with felt and does feel very substantial and very premium in your hand. Now, when we take the headphones out of the case themselves, we can see that they are slightly larger than the Mi AirDots, and there's a little nub on the top where a ear fin will actually anchor itself, and the ear fins are included with it. Now, the ear fins aren't necessarily my style. It's nice that you can put a really small ear fin on it and it's kind of unobtrusive, but if you're using them for sports or any type of real active endeavor, I would say that having the ear fins really does help give you an added point of contact and an added way to go ahead and anchor the headphones into your ear. That said, they are slightly larger than the AirDots, but I wouldn't call them bulky by any means. They still are relatively unobtrusive. Now, the sound quality of them is really, really good. I have a lot more definition in the highs and lows. They are less bass heavy and thumpy than the AirDots are, at least without any type of EQ set. Overall, I think that the sound quality coming out of them is actually a little bit better than what I got on the AirDots. I gotta say, this is all really pretty impressive, being that these headphones are under 40 bucks. They are only Bluetooth 4.2, and they are relatively kind of a budget option. And I haven't even talked about the best part yet. The best part of the QCY T1 Pro headphones is the controls. They work flawlessly, they work every time, and they are my favorite implementation of a headphone mounted touch control that I've personally used. They're better than the AirDots and they're better than the Huawei FreeBuds that are quadruple the price of it. You double tap the right side, it fast forwards to the next track, you double tap the left side, it rewinds. You to play or pause each of them, you can tap either headphone once. To activate Google Assistant, you hold it, you hear the beep, and then you're able to go ahead and use Google Assistant freely. And on the subject of Google Assistant, the microphones in the headphones themselves are actually really good. I was walking down a pretty busy street here in Hanoi, and my girlfriend could still hear me on the phone. Compare that to the AirDots, which I'll have in a video right here, which have absolutely terrible microphone quality. And these headphones, in my opinion, are an absolute steal. The battery life combined with the case, combined with the touch controls, to me, more than makes up for the lack of Bluetooth 5.0. The right headphone is the dominant headphone, just like the Mi AirDots, but similar to the Mi AirDots, you can also pair the left ear with the device if you want to use them independently. You will have to remove the right earbud from the case first and then remove the left one, but it's not that big of a deal if you really want to have a one-ear listening experience. Now, I got to say that when I was thinking about the value proposition of these headphones, or how good of a value are they for the average buyer? If I consider most other Bluetooth headphones on the market and the fact that they all range in this price segment, and I go ahead and I consider the great microphone, the excellent touch control implementation, and the phenomenal battery life when combined with the case, and I gotta say that the real price point, or the real price that I would be willing to pay for these, is probably closer to $50. I spent about $45 on my AirDots, and compared to the QCYs, I think I got a way, way worse deal buying the AirDots at $44 than I did with these QCYs at the $28 price point that you can get them for with my coupon code down below. Now, to talk about the negatives with the QCY T1 Pros, and they'd be kind of nitpicking. The first negative of them is the Bluetooth 4.2. Personally, I don't notice the biggest difference between the two of them. In fact, I think the sound quality on the QCY is better than it is on the AirDot. Also, in regards to range, the QCY only have marginally worse range than the AirDots, even though the AirDots used Bluetooth 5.0. Just like the AirDots, I can still put my phone basically in the middle of my house and get full Bluetooth coverage throughout my whole apartment. And in regards to actual just like distance, there's never a time when I'm leaving my phone more than 30 or 40 feet from me. So the added range of Bluetooth 5.0 isn't that big of a deal. The sound quality, again, like I said, I think it's better on the QCY. The second downside would be kind of the actual size of the headphone, or like the bulk factor, which the size difference between the QCY and the AirDots is quite minimal. It is noticeable, right? And you can see that it is a difference, but it is not that is not that significant of a difference. I know for all of my Indian viewers, we were talking about being able to wear the AirDots underneath a turban, and the fact that you can go ahead and wear them underneath a turban and no one knows that you're wearing headphones because they are so small. I would say that these headphones are turban compatible, just like the AirDots, but I don't wear a turban, so I can't say that. Just if people have questions regarding their compatibility with turbans, I did a fabric touch thing. You can still sometimes activate them through it. The fabric itself doesn't interfere with the touch controls, as in you're not playing pausing music if you're wearing some type of garment on your head. Hopefully that's a little extra added bonus for my people who this applies to, but for everyone else, touch controls are great. The sound quality is really, really good. The size is slightly larger than the AirDots, but it's not that big of a difference. They fit in my ears fine. I haven't had issues with them falling out. And overall, it provides everything I liked about the Mi AirDots at a similar or cheaper price with some important features which I wish the AirDots had. Okay, enough of me rambling on. If you guys do want to support my channel, I'll have affiliate links for all this stuff down below. Again, I also have an additional discount for the QC1 Pros through GearBest. And if you want to go ahead, join my Telegram group, link to that. Until next time, it's been Mitchell coming to you from Hanoi. Peace.